fans, it's Michelle Joy Phelps, and I'm joined now with Sandy Ryan. It's good to see you. Congratulations tonight. How does it feel to finally have made your professional debut?
It's been a long time coming, hasn't it? And now I've done it, I just feel happy, you know?
Yeah.
I feel like at home. Mm-hmm. The pro game's made for me, 100%.
It's so funny because not most fighters would step out and be concerned about their nails. And you just made a mention, you just broke just two nails.
Two nails. Look at them. You know how, you know the feeling.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'll be going and getting them done Monday.
So let's talk a bit about what's next. Obviously, you just had a wonderful performance. You feel good about it. Is there anything, like, I know that we're our biggest critics, aren't we? I'm literally sinking in this, by the way. Like, I'm so sorry. Oh my God, I can't even stand still. This is so bad.
I have told you now.
But we're usually our biggest critics, aren't we?
Yeah.
How do you feel ultimately about the overall performance? And
I know that there's things I can work on, but I also know they're going to come each fight. I think you've seen glimpse what I can show. Mm-hmm. But levels, like I said, mm-hmm. the weigh-in levels, I said that to her, but then she made it messy at the same time holding me. But she was tough. I feel like that was the way she could try and beat me, mm-hmm. try and rough me up and tough me up, because she couldn't box me. She couldn't win me by boxing me.
But I'm sure you're glad, though, that it went the distance, because you got the rounds in. It's obviously experience for you.
Yeah. I'm glad. Like, obviously, mm-hmm. people want to see knockouts, and they're going to come. They're going to come. Trust me. But
in due time.
Yeah. She was a tough girl. And if it was, like, messy and shit every round, then I would be like, oh, you would mm-hmm. be upset with six rounds. But I need to watch it back. But I feel like there's times where I could show bits of me, and mm-hmm. that's what I wanted to do today. I wanted to show who I am and mm-hmm. show bits of me, and so everyone knows.
So I know you're sort of testing out what weight class you would feel most comfortable in. Yeah. How did you feel overall? Do you feel like this is your weight class, or do you feel like maybe you can go up or go down?
Yeah, so that was at 145. Mm-hmm. I weighed in at 144, so I think the next fight, I think we're going to gradually bring it down.
Okay.
See how we feel. See if we get to 140. And then win more titles, and then go up, and then go again. I'm in it for the long haul. So, yeah, I want to win them more titles. And
I loved your energy at the weigh-in.
You know what?
Because you're so sweet, but on stage, I wouldn't want to mess with you.
I got a little bit of summit to me, but I'm respectful and. That's how I want to bring myself across. Mm-hmm. But if a girl was saying to me at a press conference that she said she's going to take me to the trenches, then I got to bring something back at the weigh-in. And I just told her, levels, I'm going to show you levels. Mm. So then she put her head into me and I thought, hell no. I was going back too far. I was like, oh, and I had to push her. So, yeah, I think that's a pro game, isn't it? And that's going to happen even more.
Do you almost prefer that your opponent sort of does that to you, so it sort of brings out that edge, or?
Yeah, probably. Like, it was good that it come out a little bit at the weigh-in, because then it didn't come out as much in me in the fight, because I need to be relaxed and calm, and that's when I box good, mm-hmm. and that's what Cliff was saying. She's gonna come. Don't get into a fight.
Well, you did mention that you hope to eventually in your career be considered like a Katie Taylor, to be on that level and sort of headlining her own shows. Tell me what your thoughts are overall of Katie Taylor.
Amazing, classy fighter. Mm-hmm. In and out of the ring. And I like her.
Have you met her before?
I have. And I met her in the amateur days. I met her it was 2014. We was weighing in mm-hmm. for the World Championships semi-final, I think it was. Semi-finals or finals. And I stood behind her. And so we met then. And then I went to a debut, mm-hmm. pro debut. Mm-hmm. And we know one another. She's very, I respect her.
Someone you could potentially see yourself against one day down the road?
Who knows, yeah.
Who knows?
Who knows?
Who knows? Well, you know what? Unwind, enjoy yourself. There's some really great pizza back there. Oof. Yeah, I think you deserve it.
I think, you know when you said pizza and I looked that way and Mark's out with the camera? that's Mickey smile.
I'm telling you.
You know when food's there and you're like,
No, tell me about it. Coogan goes, how many of those slices did you have? I said, four. And he goes, you have four slices of pizza. I go, mate, they're thin. Like, exactly. Not the same. But
I'd eat a full one to myself. Yeah.
Well, it's great speaking with you. Congratulations again. Any final words?
Just like to everyone at home, like, thank you supporting me, Derby people, and my teammates out in Tokyo Olympics. Like, most of them have already secured a medal, and I'm just buzzing. I'm happy for them. Aww. And all the coaches out there as well. Like, they were like my second family. Traveled the world with them. My two housemates, Lauren Price and Kara Sartingstall. Kara's got a bronze medal. Mm-hmm. She's one to watch. Lauren Price, she's like the queen of boxing. And my team, Paul, my manager, like my go-to man, Cliff, my right hand. Mm. I don't say that. They're my right hand and my go-to man. my big bro.
Well, I'm excited to see you advance in your career.
Thank you.
Hopefully we'll catch up with you soon.
Thank you very
much. All right, thank you.
Thank you.
Bye, fight fans.